फ्रैक्शनल प्रोबेबिलिटी। ओके ठीक टुडे व्हाट आई हैव प्लान इज टू कवर टुडे इज द फोर्थ क्लास व्हाट इज टोटल सो आई विल रिव्यू the concepts we have seen. So we have a concept referred to as sample space, then event, before that we have outcome, right? So let me come event. I hope now the things are better, right? Okay. So the sample space encompasses all the outcomes of an experiment. Normally we show sample space by a rectangular box like this. We can take sample space as a circular path also. But make sure that in that geometry you include all possible outcomes. Okay, so let me redraw this figure in the next page. So I have a sample space denoted like this. In this sample space, all possible outcomes of the experiment are to be included. Now I have defined mutually exclusive events. I am defining mutually exclusive events. The events are denoted by B1, B2, and so on, Bn. By mutually exclusive events, what we mean is, when I try to see common elements between two sets, is a null event. So consider event B1. See whether any element of B1 is common with the other events. They are found to be zero elements. This is what is the definition for mutually exclusive events. Likewise, you consider the commonality between another set of sets. Okay. So continue this process. Then continue this. So that's all right. So you can say Bn minus 1 intersection Bn. It is a null set. Okay. This is what is meant by mutually exclusive. There is no common element, right? Okay. I will tell you one example for this typical case. Now sample space is there, and in that sample space I have defined the events B1, B2, and so on. So how do I define events? Maybe B1 is like this, B2, B3, okay. B4. Like this, you can define a number of events, right? Maybe Bn is over here. I hope the figure is clear. A typical example could be, suppose in our institute, we consider, so EC bench, we have civil, we have, right, mechanical, we have triple E, we have. I started with EC, right, civil, mechanical, right, and so on. So many branches, right, then MME, metallurgy, chemical, right, any other I forgot? Anyone please?
CSE.
Please, CSE. Thank you. Next. Any other branch? Okay. Then management courses, right? School of management is there. Then physics branch is there. Then chemistry and so on, right? So those who are studying ECE brand are indicated as event B1. Those who are studying EEE are shown as B2 and so on, right? So the sample space, the total number of students in the campus on rolls can be viewed as those studying ECE, those studying EEE, those studying civil, those studying mechanical, and so on. This is what the sample space definition. Now I want to define an event A, maybe something like this, an event A. Define event A. So typically I want to constitute a committee in which I will take a few students from different branches. That is what my definition of constituting members of committee. And in that process, since B1, B2 and so on, they are mutually exclusive. When I try to see, the event A, let me when I try to see event A, I will find out a few members are coming from say B1, a few members are coming from B2, and so on. So probably the example could be selecting members for a say literary club. So how do you select the members? Random, right? Whoever is having exposure to the you will be picking up, right? So many people might have come from the same branch, or people might have been selected across different branches. So anything is possible. So that is the typical example I wish to take. Other examples are also possible. Only thing is you need to think over that, right? Now, when I say sample space, that sample space S is union of the events B1, B2, and so on, BN. Is it fine? Now I have defined event A. So the event A is defined. So when I say intersection of event A with some event B and intersection of event A with any other event B2. Since B1 and B2 are mutually exclusive, these events are also mutually exclusive. So this is null set, okay? That is the important observation. Okay, now let me show this event sample spaces. Events are defined something like this. Okay, so B1, B2. So event A is somewhere here. Now sample space S is defined as B1 union, B2 union, and so on, BN. Now what I do, I define event A as A intersection S. Okay, when I define event A as A intersection S, that is same as A intersection. What could be the next step? A intersection. In place of S, I will write B1 union, B2 union, and so on, BN. This also can be written as A intersection If you see the textbook, it is. Okay, I will stop here. Okay. Now I want to see the probability of event A. So the probability of event A is simply probability of A intersection B1 union B2 union and so on. Now, the probability of A becomes probability of A intersection B1. So, union is replaced with addition A intersection B2 and so on. I should include the last event that is defined on sample space. Yes. Suppose from a particular branch there is no participation, the probability of that branch intersection, A intersection that branch becomes zero. Okay. So that is how probability of event A is defined as. Now, from definition of conditional probability, so what the probability of an event A given event B is given by the ratio of joint probability A and B by probability of B. The condition is the event B should occur with definite probability, however small it is. Okay. The same conditional probability can also be defined by interchanging the terms. Okay. So I can also define the conditional probability of B given A as the ratio of joint probability to probability of A. Now what is the condition to be mentioned here, provided probability of occurrence of A is not zero. Okay. So this is what the conditional probability definition. Now let us apply the conditional probability concept to the present case. What is the present case? Probability of A equal to probability of A intersection B. Let me write down. Plus probability of A intersection B2 plus and so on. How many terms? Since there are n events defined on sample space, I should consider all the n events, right? Okay. Now this is where we are. Now the conditional probability of A given B1. What is this probability of A intersection B1 by probability of B1? So let us introduce this concept. Okay. Then probability of A intersection A given B2 is similarly ratio of joint probability to probability B2. Like this, we will get the terms. So the total probability P of A of event A happening is probability of in place of A intersection B1, let us write down conditional probability of event A given B1 into probability of B1. One is there, please take care. Plus probability of A given B2 times probability of B2. Okay, and so on. How many terms do we get? N terms. Suppose on a particular committee, participation from a particular branch is not there, whatever is the reason, right? So the probability of ECE branch participating in that committee is zero. Say P of B1 is zero. So the first term on the right hand side of this equality sign disappears, right? So the total probability of event A is given by the expression P of A equal to P of A given B1 times P of B1, that's all, right? So how do I write this? I write this expression as summation of probability of A given Bi given Bi times P of Bi. All uppercase letters are reserved for probability or events where I is running from 1 to N. Is it okay? So the same notation we can incorporate here as well, right? This I avoided only to reduce the notations, right? Here also we can incorporate. How do we incorporate AU intersection summation B? Okay. Let us avoid right now there. In the final expression, I am putting down this summation. This is P of A. So if you recollect the first figure, the sample space, yes, so many events have been defined, say B1, B2, B3 and so on, B4, B5, okay, this is Bn. I have defined an event A, this is event A. So the probability of event A taking place is dependent on so many terms, n terms. In each term, there is product of conditional probability and probability. Okay. This is what we mean by total probability of an event. Now, let us take the definition of conditional probability. So, what is the definition for conditional probability? The conditional probability is defined as the ratio of two probabilities, right? Okay, let me use a different page. Okay, okay. The probability of A given B equal to probability of A intersection B by probability of A. This definition for conditional probability. Probability of B given A also should be defined. It is the ratio of joint probability of events B and A by P of A. By definition, the joint probability of A and B is same as the joint probability of events B and A. So, taking a clue from this, what I can write is the probability of occurrence of A given B equal to, by definition, it is A inter probability of A intersection B by probability of B. The numerator expression is replaced with, from this I will take probability of B given A into probability of A. Is it okay? Then how to remember this expression? It is very simple. Probability of A given B equal to probability of B given A times probability of A by probability of B. How to remember this important expression? On the left hand side of the equality sign, we have P of A given B. On the right hand side, see the denominator. It should be P of B. The reason is P P of A given B on the left hand side, when multiplied with P of B in the denominator, should give us the joint probability P of A intersection B. Is it fine? Should be equal to joint probability A intersection B. What should be there in the numerator on the right hand side of the equality sign? On the numerator, we should have probability of A intersection B. Probability of A intersection B can also be written as probability of B given A times probability of A. That is what I wrote on the right hand side in the numerator part. Okay, this is very interesting case. This is what we mean by Bayes' theorem. Okay. So what Bayes' theorem says, it is logically explained, right? This is by definition of conditional probability. This is also by definition of conditional probability. So when you see these two expressions, on the right hand side, the numerator is same. If that is the case, let us modify the terms on the right hand side, numerator part. That is what this expression in the rectangular box is appearing. Okay, this is what we mean by Bayes' theorem, right? Let us see a few examples related to these concepts. So one is total probability and the other one is Bayes' theorem. Okay, so once I defined P of A given B as, I am reproducing this expression within this rectangular box, P of A given B as. So next time I will write the expression in the numerator. How do I write down the terms? Since on the left hand side I have A given B, on the right hand side I will write A B given A. Since the first term on the right hand side numerator is P of P given A, it should be multiplied with P of A. Is it okay? Please consistently follow the same sequence. First you write down the expression on the left hand side. Okay. Then write down the denominator of the expression on the right hand side. Then write down the expression in the numerator part. So follow the same sequence, then things become clear. What is the total probability theorem? Just now we have seen. So now the numerator remains as it is. In the case of denominator, what I do? Probability of event B. Now I define a sample space. In this sample space, events now I will change. Say A1, A2, A3 and so on, right? So B is what is being defined. If B is defined like this, I can replace B by P of B given A1 into P of A1 plus P of B given A2 into P of A2 and so on, right? Is it fine? Any questions, please?
Fine, sir. Fine. Fine.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. So, based on the context, you can get B, N, N or something like that. Okay. Now, I want to quote an example from Jeevan Vidya, okay? From the concept of this or from your UHV course, right? Both are same. Now for your happy living. Sample space is happy living. On how many things do you depend upon? Can you please identify? For your happy living, on what things do you depend upon? I depend upon my laptop, with internet connection. Okay, this is one unit. Now I am sitting or I am using a table and chair because I have to keep my laptop, I have to keep my say modem and so on, right? Then what else? I am using headphones. Any question, please?
AC, I am telling, sir.
Please repeat.
I am saying that AC, sir, AC.
Yeah, AC. AC. Okay, thank you. I will write simply AC. Any other thing, please?
Sir, mobile.
From my
mobile. Mobile,
mobile. Mobile, okay. Any other thing? Any other thing? I am extending the box.
TV.
What is?
TV, television.
TV, okay. TV. Any other thing? Please respond. If you respond, the class becomes interesting.
Food.
Right?
Food.
Known to you. Please repeat.
Food.
Food, okay, food, right, thank you. Any other thing?
Home.
Home.
Car, bike.
No, no, one of you.
Car, bike.
Home.
Car.
Car, I will write down car also, no. Car, home, okay. Any other thing?
Books, sir. Books.
This is subset of money, I think.
Subset of?
Money.
Money, I will write, okay? Whatever it is. Okay, money.
Sir, property. Property, sir.
Property, okay. Any other thing? These are enough if, for your happy living.
No.
Please.
Family.
One of you. Please. Repeat.
Tools. Vacation. Tools.
Which tools?
Tools. You are asking only about objects or like all.
No, everything.
Elements, tools.
See, happy living.
Vacation.
Happy
sir,
living.
Vacation. Holiday vacation. Holiday,
holiday?
Vacation. Good. Vacation.
Vacation. Okay.
Family.
Vacation.
Sir.
Family.
Vacation. Family.
Any other thing?
Of mine.
Friends. Friends, sir.
Friends. Okay. Friends. See, if I have not included what you said, please repeat. Every contribution is very important. You will appreciate this example. Okay.
Sir, so donation.
Donation.
Donation. Donation.
Okay, what you give to others? Any other thing? So, anyone want to add anything? Okay. I will precisely represent this sample space for happy living, like I will write material order. Material order means whatever you find in nature in the form of water, earth, soil, then the minerals, whatever is found within the earth, and air, then sun, moon, everything comes under material order. See, your laptop, table, chair, internet connectivity, headphone, AC, mobile, TV, car, home, all have come under material. Is it fine? Up to home, it has come under material. See, okay? This entire thing is material. If you want to add some more things, please add. Don't hesitate. This gives very good insight. Okay? So material order. Then somebody said books. I will come to it later. Then somebody said food. So what food comprises of, please tell me. What do you
any,
mean?
Any food that you like to eat, food, your favorite food. Desserts.
Desserts. So desserts.
Healthy and nutritious food. Healthy and nutritious food.
Nutritious food, okay.
Delicious food, like tasty.
Okay. Okay, delicious. Any other thing?
Health conscious food like ragi.
What I mean is, I accept all the things. Food comes from plants, that is fruits. Food also comes from animals, right?
Meat.
You have milk on your table. You have a cup of coffee on your table. Milk is there. So that is what I mean by food coming from animals, right? Now, so your dependency on plants is evident. Your dependency on animals is evident, right? So what I do is, for happy living, we require contribution from material order. We require contribution from plant order as well as animal order. Is it accepted? Somebody said.
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you. Somebody said money. Money, I will not come. Property, I will not come. Family, someone said. Family, friends. Very nice. I will tell you the meaning behind this also. Family and friends. So, material, plant, human order. These are the four orders in nature. So, for our happy living, we require so many things, and these things are coming from different orders. That is very essential to be realized. So, some of you said family is important, friends is important. Somebody said AC is important, car is important, laptop is important. No doubt they are important. Right? Somebody said food is important for happy living. Okay. So, for happy living, which is the most important thing? So, in UHV, we say it is right understood. Is it right? Okay. Now, thus, let me relate this example to our concept in PDSP. Sample space A is defined as union of B1, B2, B3 and B4. These are all mutually exclusive. Do you agree, please? What is found in material order cannot be found in animal order or plant order or human order. Okay. So I can use a dried plant, tree, dried tree. So that I can prepare a wood, I can prepare a table, wooden chair, okay, wooden almara, or wooden some piece, artistic value, a piece that has got artistic value. From animal, you can get meat, you can get milk, you can get service also. See the bulls that do the plowing in fields. See the buffaloes, cows that give milk to human beings. So, in our concept, the sample space is B1 union, B2 union, B3 union, B4. Now, I am defining event A. That event A is components that contribute to happy living. What are the components? Definitely, I require. This is how I am defining event A. If you are seeing, I am showing a dashed line, event A. Okay. So, for happy living, I require my laptop, I require table, I require my family, I require friends, I require coffee or tea or milk. Okay. Now, what this concept says, probability of, let me show the same expression, P of A given B, yes, before this, right, yes, P of A equal to P of A given B1. Okay, let me write down that. P of A equal to S. P of A equal to P of A given B1 into P of B1. P of A given B2 into P of 2, P of B2, and so on, right? So what this expression says, for my happy living, what is the probability of B1 ensuring my happy living? That is what it says. What is this first expression, A intersection B1? How much of happiness do I get if I select B1? Or what is the joint probability of A and B1? Then, what is the second term over here says? What is the probability of ensuring my happy living when I select element from, say, B1 is, say, material order, B2, say, plant order, B3, say, animal order, B4, say, human order. So, how much of happiness or how much of happy living do I get if I select an element from material order, an element from plant order, or an element from animal order or from human order? That is what this expression says. Okay. Is it fine? Sometimes it depends on the situation, right? Is this example is appealing or no? So, please respond.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, thank you. So, that is what I wanted to see, the relation between this and our concept, okay? Whatever you do, and some of you have forgotten, who is bringing the milk packet to your house? Somebody said food, somebody said family, friends. Who is bringing the milk packet to your house? Let me add a few things. The vendor is bringing. Who is bringing newspaper to your house? The paper boy is bringing. Who is providing the groceries when you place an order online? Some other person is coming. So, in addition to family and friends, here others are there who are making your life so comfortable. Fine. Now the question is, when you see plants and animals, animals eat leaves of plants and animals leave manure for the plants. What do plants do? They grow up, take fertility from the soil. They drop dried leaves, create fertilizer for the soil, improves the quality of the soil, right? So these two units are helping one and another. Similarly, when it comes to material order, soil and plant, they are helping one and another. Okay? Plants grow in soil, plants give dried leaves to make the soil fertile. And material and animal order, both are helping one another. When it comes to human being is taking plants, fruits from plants, but what he is doing in return, he is cutting down the trees to get necessary material for making paper and so on, right? He is, animals are giving milk to the human beings. What human being is doing, you know, okay. So the material order, earth, inside the earth we have petroleum, natural gas and so on, and coal, right? We are taking away all the things from the soil or earth. So the material order is giving so much to the human being. What the human being is doing, I am putting dashed lines, doubtful. No contribution. So it is in this context UHV has been introduced. Every human being must be conscious of his contribution to the remaining four actors. In what way he can contribute? You plant, water the plants, or you put new plants and make sure that they grow properly. That is one aspect. When it comes to animals, treat them with love, affection. Make sure that you grow more number of animals. When you see an animal is going away from this planet, suppose those who are taking non-vegetarian food, if they see that one animal is cut down, make sure that you contribute to the growth of at least two such things, three such things, so that there is a balance. Okay. And when it comes to material, we are taking so much of coal from the earth, but what is replacing that space? Okay. So that is the concept of knowing about UHV, right? Okay. That is the example related to UHV. Then Bayes theorem also we have seen. Okay. Let us see one more example that is related to ECE branch. Okay. So in ECE, we frequently speak about communication, right? And this communication is in the form of binary communication. By binary communication, what we mean? The symbols to be transmitted are, the symbols are represented by 0 and 1. So I have a channel. On the left hand side of the channel, I have transmitter. Okay. On the right hand side, I have receiver. Now I am speaking from my room. You are listening. So the transmitter can be the teacher, the receiver can be student. What is the channel that exists between me and you? It includes space, free space, right? Okay. Now, whenever I am speaking, there are cases where whatever I have spoken might be heard properly. Yes or no? So, whatever I have spoken, say sentence B naught or word B naught, that might have been received properly. So B naught is received at the receiver side properly. RX means receiver, TX means transmitter. Okay. So another word is spoken, say B1, that might have been received as B1 at the receiver side. So what these lines say, when B0 is transmitted, it appears perfectly as B0 at the receiver side. When B1 is spoken, that B1 appears perfectly as it is at the receiver side. Since we are considering two symbols, say B naught refers to say 0, B1 refers to say 1. Only two symbols to be transmitted. So B naught refers to 0 symbol, B1 refers to symbol 1. When B naught is transmitted, that would be received as symbol 0 at the receiver side. And in fact, B stands for before the channel. A stands for after the channel. So that is how remember the things, after the channel. Where is the channel? This horizontal line is the channel. Separating transmitter and receiver, we have the channel. Now the question is, do you receive whatever I speak all the time the same? No, sometimes a different thing might be heard, making you uncomprehensible about what I told. In such a case, what I consider is sometimes B0 would be received as A1, possible, sometimes if I spell B1, that would have been received as A0. So we have two cases. One is the case of correct transmission. The other one is the case of erroneous reception, okay? We can say correct reception, okay? That would be a nice word. Correct reception, erroneous reception. When you are at the receiver side, suppose you stand at the receiver side, you heard at a you heard that a word has been received. Okay. When you receive word A naught, there is the possibility that B naught is actually transmitted or B1 is actually transmitted. There is some ambiguity about which has been transmitted. Okay. Similarly, when you receive a word, say A1, you are not very clear about whether B0 is transmitted or B1 is transmitted. There is ambiguity for it. Now, my intention is to know what is the probability of receiving A0. What does it mean? What is the probability of receiving symbol 0 at the receiver side? Symbol 0 can be received in two cases. Case 1, when B symbol 0 is transmitted at the transmitter side and symbol 1 is transmitted at the transmitter side. But there is a finite probability associated with selection of symbol 0 at the transmitter side for transmission. There is a finite probability associated with symbol 1 being selected for transmission at the transmitter side. Is it clear? So, what is the probability of receiving A0 given that B0 was transmitted? So, the upper horizontal line directed from A0 to from B0 to A0 is probability of receiving A0 given B0 was transmitted. On the lower side, we have probability of receiving A1 when B1 was transmitted. So it is conditional probability. Let us see the line connecting B0 and A1. B0 to A1. Okay. What is being received? A1 is received. So here I have the case of A1 being received when B0 was transmitted. Okay, this is what the line. Now consider the line connecting B1 and A0. What is received? A0 is received. What is being transmitted? B1 is transmitted. Okay. These are the conditional probabilities. Okay, on the transmitter side, I have probability for selection of B0, probability for selection of B1. Is it clear? So, on the receiver side, I have probability of receiving A0. On the right hand side, I am writing, please, probability of receiving A1. Is it clear? So, what are the probabilities in this example? P of A0, P of A1, P of B0, and P of B1. Okay, let me write down. Probability of B0, probability of B1. Where are they? They are at the transmitter side. I have probability of A1, A0 and probability of B1. Where are they? They are at the receiver side. Receiver are right hand side, okay? This is at on the left hand side. What are the conditional probabilities? Receiving A0. When it is given that B0 is transmitted, receiving A0 when B1 is transmitted, this is with reference to receiving symbol A naught. What is the probability of receiving A1 when B naught is transmitted? What is the probability of receiving A1 when B1 is transmitted? Okay. These are with reference to symbol A1. See, how many probabilities are there? How many conditional probabilities are there? Now, I want to know the probability of receiving A0. The probability of receiving A0 is dependent upon conditional probabilities as well as probabilities, right? What could be the answer, please? I can receive A0 when B0 is transmitted. Also, I receive A0 when B1 is transmitted. Is it clear? There are two possibilities for receiving A0. Now, when I consider conditional probability, P of A0 given B0, but what is the probability of selecting B0? So, this product gives me the joint probability of selecting, receiving A0 when B0 is selected. Okay. So, the second term on the right hand side of equality sign should include probability of selecting B1 for transmission. This is how we compute probability of receiving A0. Similarly, what is the probability of receiving A1? Probability of receiving A1 when B0 is transmitted. This is what that probability. Then probability of receiving A1 when B1 is transmitted, that is the product of conditional probability and probability of the conditioning event. This is how PA0, PA1 are to be computed. So PA0 and PA1 are to be computed. What is given one? Given things are simply probability of selecting B0 for transmission, probability of selecting B1 for transmission, and what is the probability of receiving A0 when B0 is sent, probability of receiving A0 when B1 is sent. Similarly, receiving A1 when B0 is sent, probability of receiving A1 when B1 is sent. Okay. These six probabilities are given to us, and we need to compute these two probabilities. Is it clear? So there is a problem being worked out in the textbook. Let us visit that problem. This is the theory for that material. So let me see. The textbook example. The binary communication system, we say, the reason is only two symbols are to be transmitted. So, symbol 0 and symbol 1. Multiple. So, I have gone beyond the desired page. My intention is to show the example related to this binary communication system. This is what I am going to explain. So this is the okay. I hope the figure is clear to you. See the title for this figure written at the bottom of the page. Binary symmetric communication system diametrical model, okay, applicable to example. Okay, is a binary communication system. Why is it called symmetrical? See the answer. On the left hand side, we have B1, B2. I have used B0, B1. Okay, no problem, right? So B1 is prompt of selecting symbol 0 or 1, symbol 1. B2 is about symbol 0. Okay. So two symbols are to be transmitted. P of B1 is given in the problem. P of B2 is also given in the problem. So how many symbols are to be transmitted? Only two symbols. What are the elements in the sample space? B1 and B2. When B1 and B2 are the elements in the sample space. Only two elements, say B0, B1. So, if another thing is B0 union B1 is sample space S. What should be probability of B0 B1 union? Should be 1. What does this expression mean? Probability of B0 plus probability of B1 should be 1. In this example that is given in the textbook, probability of B1 is 0.6, probability of B2 is equal to 0.4. Sum of these two probabilities is 1. That means I have considered all the possible symbols. That is a cross check for us. Okay. On the right hand side of the figure, we have A1, A2. What is A1? Receiving symbol B1. What is A2? Receiving symbol B2. Okay. These are to be computed. That's why the values are not listed. So, connecting B1 and A1 on the top side of the figure, you have probability of A1 given B1. How do you read that? Probability of receiving A1 given B1. Given B1 means B1 was transmitted. What is the probability of receiving that as A1? So, the probability is listed as 0.9. Okay. When B1 was transmitted, it could be received as A2 also. So, probability of A2, receiving A2 given B1, it is 0.1. Okay. When it comes to transmission, when B1 is transmitted, or it could be received as A2. There is no other alternative, right? Only two possible cases. Sum of those two possible cases must be, probabilities of those two cases must be 1. Now you see probability of A1 given B1 plus probability of A2 given B1. It is 0.9 plus 0.1. So 1. That is true. Next, when you consider transmission of B2, I am referring to left hand side of the diagram. Left hand bottom corner. Okay. When B2 is transmitted, it could be received as A1 or it could be received as A2. See the corresponding conditional probabilities, sum them. So 0.1 plus 0.9. So the two probabilities summation results in 1. Okay. It is called symmetric channel. The reason is, what is P of A1 given B1? It is 0.9. What is the conditional probability of A2 given B2? It is 0.9. Whether you send B1, what is the probability of B1 being received as A1? That probability is same as the probability of B2 being received as A2. Also, the erroneous probabilities. Probability of receiving B2 when A1 was transmitted. Probability of receiving A2 when B1 was transmitted. It is same as probability of receiving A1 when B2 was transmitted. There is symmetry. That's why it is called symmetric channel. Okay. So, the numericals I have. These expressions I have explained to you. So, P of A1 given B1 given A2. What is it? In the denominator, A2 should be there. In the numerator, the conditioning events gets rearranged, right? P of A2 given B1 times P of B1. So, this is how this problem is worked out. Please go through this example. Okay. When we meet again, I will be discussing independent events. Any questions, please? Any questions, please? I think no one has given anything message on. Yes, a few messages are there. Okay. Relations. relations. Okay, family, friends, relations actually includes under family or friends. Okay, no problem. Okay, thank you for staying with me for this much of time. So I am closing the session for today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.